Hey gang, Devin here from American Aquarium. Had an interesting question from one of our sick fish forums. We run one of the biggest sick fish forums on Facebook. Check it out, Sick Fish Aquatics. It was about hole in the head or lateral line disease, one of the two. It's very similar. And they were like, hey, there's not very much information out there, and all the information says that it's not conclusive about what is causing the disease and the deterioration of the front of the head. Okay, well, I'll tell you what we do know. When we've been able to maintain hundreds and thousands of aquariums over time, and anytime we came across the tank that had a fish with this disease, what we found is that there was a lack of mineralization and also a poor feeding habit. And then so when we switched over to our maintenance, what our typical routine was is we would focus on mineralization, giving a constant source of electrolyte minerals and your GEH, that's where you can find in the measurement. And then we also upped feeding with quality food, not something that's like the Tetra brands, and there's a whole list of things that are just real poor quality foods. And I will tell you that of the thousands of aquariums, ponds that we kept, we never had a single case of the disease. So what does that tell us? Is that mineralization is a huge key. It's going to boost immunity, but also the calcium, all the other minerals are gonna just, the osmoregulation of the fish is just gonna be so much better. And then also the feeding, you know, you're getting your minerals and all the nutrition that way. And so all these things are also boosting immunity. So when it's not only just like you're fighting the symptom, but you're also going after the cause, which is keeping immunity boosted and not letting it wear down. And then also an extra, even just better than better with these two things. We had no cases with just those two, but if you ever wanted to add UVC to your aquarium, then it's just almost a slam dunk deal that you'll never have a hole in the head type of issue. So those are the three things that we found were going to make it so you never have this disease. Never had it one time in thousands of aquariums that we kept. So hope that information helps. Please like, subscribe, share. Hope you guys enjoyed question of the day. Ask your questions, and if it's something that I'm able to answer or if it's an interesting question, of course I'll go ahead and try to make a video, pass you along to one of our information articles, because I'm just trying to get so much of our information that is a huge amount out there and easy digestible versions to you guys. So hope that helped. Talk to you guys next time. All right, cool, bye. Okay, I kind of forgot what I was going to show you guys. See, I get talking so fast. But hey, one easy recommendation for your mineralization when it comes down to what you'd see in our articles are our AAP Wonder Shells. It's a mineral block, calcium, magnesium, some other trace minerals. You do this baby in your aquarium and it slowly dissolves. It kind of adds the water and needs it. And this is super beneficial for many different type of fish. More freshwater, of course. Your saltwater, your fish are already going to have a huge amount of minerals, so you're not going to typically need it. But for freshwater fish, check out the AAP Wonder Shell. And then two, if you're looking for the best fish food that you could possibly get on the market, AAP just came out with the all-natural line right here. We got herbivore, omnivore, carnivore. And when it comes to no fillers, no wheat-based foods, the makeup of the food is just so much higher quality, and it's guaranteed to be the best food on the market. And so you'd want to check out something like that, AAP Natural Foods. I'm not even going to give you suggestions of other things, because I recommend this one over every other food on the market. All right, so cool. Sorry about that. That was an add-on. Talk to you guys later. Bye.